Hi, I'm Kerry from eSpares, and in this video I'm going to show you how to use a multimeter to test whether or not your washing machine door lock is faulty and how to replace it if needed. However, before replacing a part, it's always a good idea to make sure that you test it first to make sure that the issue doesn't lie elsewhere. This is where the multimeter comes in. Now, it's important to mention that the process may differ depending on the make and model of your appliance. However, the steps should be similar, so let's take a look. Before starting, it's helpful to understand what multimeters actually are. Multimeters are handy tools that can be used to measure the electrical resistance in a circuit. In simple terms, this means that they can be used to test electrical parts and components to determine whether or not they're working properly. If you don't own a multimeter, you can buy one from our website through a link in the description below. To test and possibly replace your washer's door lock, you will need a flathead screwdriver and, of course, your multimeter. You may also need a new door lock, so we'll include a link to where you can buy a new one in the description. And remember, safety first. Always make sure you switch off your appliance and unplug it from the mains before carrying out any work. If your water supply hose isn't long enough for you to pull the machine out, then you may need to disconnect the hose from the machine. If you do need to disconnect the hose from the machine, make sure you turn off your mains water supply first. Also, make sure you have a towel at the ready just to soak up any water that may spill when disconnecting your hose. To access and test the door lock, you'll first need to remove the clamp band from around the door seal. You can do this by working your flathead screwdriver behind the band and working it free. With the band removed, you can push the door seal back inside the door frame, like so. This will get the seal out of the way, allowing you to access the door lock. Now, to disconnect the door lock, pop your hand inside, hold the door lock, and then use your screwdriver to push in the two small studs above and below the lock. This will then allow you to push the lock free. You can then also go ahead and disconnect the door lock's electrical connection. Now it's time to test the door lock. First, make sure the multimeter is on and set to the resistance setting or ohms. Then stick the two prongs into number 1 and number 2 tags on the door lock. If the door lock is working properly, it will show a reading that is over 1,000 ohms. If there is no reading, the door lock may be faulty and will need to be replaced. Now it's time to fit your new door lock, but before buying a new door lock, you need to make sure that you know your washing machine's model number. This is so that you can get the correct part for your make and model appliance. Now, if you're not sure what the model number is or where to find it, don't worry. Check out our video on finding your washing machine's model number here. To fit your new door lock, first reconnect it to the electrical connection. Then slot the door lock into place, making sure both of the small studs slot firmly into place above and below. Then with the new door lock in place, you can refit the seal by pulling it back out and making sure it's in place all the way around the lip. Finally, refit the clamp band into place, into the groove, all the way around the seal. Use your flathead screwdriver to help if necessary. Don't forget to reattach your water supply hose if you removed it earlier. Turn on your mains water supply and, of course, plug the machine back in at the mains. And there you have it, how to test and replace the door lock on your washing machine. Now that your washing machine is back in working order, it's a good idea to make yourself familiar with the settings and programs to make sure that you're getting the best results. Check out our video on a complete guide to washing machine settings and how to use them here. Before you go, don't forget to subscribe to our channel for appliance repairs, maintenance guides and all things eSpares. Thanks for watching.